Welcome to the Z.Ram YouTube channel. My name is Daniel and in today's video I wanted to introduce you to our ZR50 case and go more into detail and show you how to install all the parts, i.e. change the case. This was the first version, the new version is a little smoother. Here you can still see a few layers, here too, but it's much smoother than before. And the new thing is that we now also have it in black. The first version was only in silver, now we have that in black too. We have the silver here with a reddish brown, and with the black we have a some darker brown here. What I would be interested in is how do you like the colors and would you like other colors here for the handles? Suggestions would be very interesting, maybe just make black handles. I would like to know what you think about it. So, I've installed everything here and here it is, all the HDR50 innards are in there. And today, I just wanted to put the innards into the black case and show you how it looks when finished and show you how to put the pieces in place. Well, I would say let's get started. I have already installed all the parts in the case. I'll open it now and get the parts out again. In principle, this is almost the same as when you do it with your original HDR50. You just open all these screws here and you can open it. I'll open the screws now and remove the barrel cover. I've now removed the tuning barrel cover here, just loosen the screws slightly here, then you can pull it off like this. You don't have to open it completely, and I've removed the extension from the tuning barrel. And here are the screws from the case. You just assume that this is the standard HDR50 and open all the screws and you can then open the housing, which is basically the same as the HDR50. You will need all the screws, plus, if you order the parts from us, you will get 2 additional screws for the housing and 10 additional screws, actually 8, but 2 spares, for the handles. In any case, you will definitely need the screws from your case. That's the first thing you need from your standard HDR50 housing. This is how it unfolds, just like the original HDR50. And now here's the inside of the HDR50. This is where the barrel is installed, and this is also where the Z-Extension is installed. As you can see, this is attached and completely disappears into this case here. That is also the main reason why we developed the housing so that the Z-Extension is simply protected from falling, and that it cannot be seen and that this has such a neat look. And as you can see here, it is also a very high quality, very stable and stiff. As you can see, this is all full. With the original case, this isn't full, it's just thin plastic. But here it's filled, so it's actually a bit more stable than a standard case. Anyway, you take all this little stuff out here. You will need that too. And take this whole thing out here, you're going to need the barrel, and this. So those are the parts you need out of your HDR50. Barrel, this whole thing, this and the screws. And so we can continue with that here. Now here we have the black case. Back here, for those who don't know it yet, is our Z-Extension, which increases the volume in the chamber and thus provides more power. This is then screwed on here, where the brass cap is normally on, and the brass cap is then later screwed onto the Z-Extension here. Glue both together with some screw glue, then it will hold. This is high-quality stainless steel, so the threads aren't going to snap or anything on their own. Anyway, you can use it here. Very simple assembly, you don't have to open this housing. You can screw the Z-Extension directly here and then insert it into the housing. And then the tuning barrel comes in here again. Make sure the spring is right here. And then this part right here. With the rounding up. So that this fits through here, and now you put that on top of it like this. It is important that the barrel can move and is under pressure. That's it. Now I put the screws in everywhere and put the handles on and then screw them together. I've now screwed the housing. All the screws are in here. The barrel moves. The part moves too. And that works too. So, the whole thing is here, we have four screws here, so this part is screwed very well, very stable. And when the handles are added here, four more screws come in here. That means this whole area is very stable. So even if something were to burst here, you are safer here with the housing, since this is secured here with so much material and so many screws than if you use the standard housing. The Z-Extension is also a little safer here, the housing also ensures that you are on the safe side. So, now I screw the handles together. There are a total of 10 screws that you get with the set, 4 screws for each of these handles, one on this side, one on this side. And there is one more screw on the housing than on the standard, you get that extra, and one screw is simply a reserve. So you get 10 screws and you get 8 for the handle, 1 for the case and 1 as a spare. So, I'm doing the handles here now. So, now I've also installed the handle. That would now be the standard version, without the extension for the barrel. Then we still have the extension here, which I'll mount right here. But as it is, it already serves its purpose, it looks cool, it hides the Z-Extension back here, makes it a little more secure. And thanks to the Z-Extension we have more power here, we have also installed the power pin, which also adds a few more joules. We completely removed the block in the chamber and we completely removed the valve here in the grip. Well, this means that we now have the maximum possible performance here. There will probably be a few fewer shots with it, but if it's not enough shots for you, you can add the modify pin here. This reduces the performance a little, but you then have more shots available again. However, I still recommend that if you install all this stuff, that you also install the tuning barrel with the extension. Because then the whole performance is much more effective, because we then have a longer barrel where all this additional energy, more air, space and time to unfold during valve opening. So I now mount the extension here. That's the standard extension that comes with the tuning barrel. There is also the sniper extension here, which you would screw in here and then the whole thing is a little longer. It's more interesting if you would now connect the ASA to chamber adapter here, you can still do that here now. You would simply screw the ASA to chamber adapter onto the Z-Extension and could then screw a bottle on here. And then here the sniper extension, then maybe another grip here, and then you have a really cool long setup. I did a similar setup in another video, which I'll link to you here above, only without the housing. In principle, you can also rebuild the whole thing there. There is also a corresponding offer in our shop, one with the ZR50 housing and one without. Anyway, let's continue here. We screwed on the barrel extension, now the barrel cover is used here. You can also buy it separately, so you don't have to buy it together. It's available separately and you would have to order it as well. The first thing I would do here is screw the screws in. So, you just screw the screws in here lightly. and then you slide this on and tighten the screws again. So it's screwed down now. There's still a bit of play here, it has to be, for the barrel. Now we have the black ZDR50 version with barrel extension and the accompanying cover. Then we have the punch button for the handle, which also belongs in the set, is also included in the set. That hides this quite well, the gap is also very small, that's quite enough to pierce the capsule. And then the drum. You have to remove this part from the standard drum from the HDR50 and put it in here. If that has a bit too much play, you can glue it. But if it's a little harder to push in, then you can leave it that way. You get that out like this, or press on it from the side, from behind, and then it comes out. Anyway, here you can also use the Z50 V2 projectiles now. 6 grams. With grooves that during the shot spin the projectile during the flight, and very sharp. Very pointed and very sharp. You load them from behind, they sit perfectly in the drum. So that's basically finished here. I think that looks really cool. I especially like the brown handle, it looks a bit like wood. This filament from the 3D printer is a wood plastic mixture, so there is actually wood in it, and it also feels very nice and handy in the hand, it feels very good. Well, basically that's what I wanted to show you today. We'll be also shooting soon. Unfortunately, my crony is defective and I'm having it exchanged right now, and they take their time with it, which is why there are currently no crony videos. I also wanted to shoot a video with the FSC and the ASA to chamber adapter, i.e. Tiberius FSC Pepperball TCP with the ASA to chamber adapter, but I need the crony for that. And as soon as that's there, I'll make a video with it again. Today, I just wanted to show you our ZDR50 black case again, and that was it. Write in the comments what I could change, what I can improve in future versions of the ZDR50 case. In principle, we will try different materials. But I would be interested to know which grip color you prefer, if all of this is too colorful for you. I am already considering offering a black grip anyway, which you can then choose as well. And then it would almost be like that again, looks like the original HDR50, except that the Z extension is still hidden. That's basically the main reason why we made the case. Okay, so I'm curious about your suggestions and looking forward to your suggestions. Otherwise, please give a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel for more content, and have a nice day. You're Daniel from Z.Ram.